This has my head spinning. Crazy. Kitty, lower the screen.
Bravo! It's right here. One button. That's all you have to do. Right here.
All right. Cue the fire. I'll do it. What do I pay her for? This right here. This happened today because of one guy, one dude, and one tweet sent this market a crashing. But that's not even the biggest story today. But from story after story, we have a signal that went off. It sounds kind of like that. Well, it is a bearish signal, plus a lot more. That's from Business Insider, and Bloomberg says end of the bull market. So you guys ready? Oh, and don't forget about all the riots that are happening. Boy, didn't I say this was going to happen? Even Peter Schiff, this is not Peter Schiff, is sounding the alarm. I mean, I know. We tend to sound alarms. But he is saying this is the most obvious financial crisis and no one sees it. And I'm like, Peter, I see it, but we got the Fed feeling so blessed that the Federal Reserve, what's the punchline, is going to drop interest rates back to zero by, about a month. Wouldn't that be so nice? Ah, so good. And actually, looking at this image, because she looks about 29. She 29? I'm going to go with she's 29. Do you know that almost half of 29-year-olds still live in their mom's basement? Well, I mean, I don't know if it's the basement, but they can't make it. No, that dream that we all had, that American dream, buy that house and have that career. Poof. And how about that stock market, S&P 500? We got a little time left. Kind of flat there, a little negative. NASDAQ's up, the Dow's down. I don't care. Any way you dice this thing up, you're going to close. You closed on Friday under the 200, and you're getting a full candle close under the 200 again. And not just that, that trend line right there that goes, we're under it, goes way, 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 way back. So get ready for this bear market. But NASDAQ's fine. Well, okay. Three down, one to go. Extremely bearish chart formation signals the top seven big tech stocks. So you may want to take your profit, because now you got a lot of people on the other side that are shorting the F out of this. Also, if you want to learn how to do it, link in the description. You don't have to just short it. You can buy a put. You can sell a call. Imagine how much you could have made on that Tesla put. If you're trying to get into it and you can't, I'm sorry. Come back tomorrow. Click on the link. Also, I got an email. Someone's like, $199 a month. That might be a little expensive if you're not done filming yet and you're going to do... I'm probably going to do about 80 videos. I have about 70 in there right now. But then I said, it's not $199. It's total. You own the whole course for $199. He's like, oh, that's a great deal. Especially when it goes to $299 and $3, because as I'm filming, we keep it there. And also my other ones came down because no one could get in. So grab those, because in the coming days, they all go back up. Start with a swing trade, do my bear market. That's what we're in now. When these digits go down, your account goes up. Extremely bearish chart. We got top seven. We got Apple, Nvidia, Tesla face elevated risk of a sell-off. But what is this signal? Because I don't see it here. You know, Bravo likes signals. Okay, find me chart. Here we is. What is that? I've actually seen this on Kitty. Magnificent seven stock chart scene. Double top pattern. Dump, dump, dump. There it is. Actually, both of these have been in my courses on how to trade it. Tesla, I took out a short for the win. Amazon in my options course, I think I shorted that. I don't remember. Actually, I took out a buy on Amazon above the 200. I ain't shorting that one yet. And this is the same thing. Beatdown. Oh, 7, 8, 9. We start getting a little pink. That's when you completely lose circulation and you go past the 9. That updates. That's a coming. And I put in a buy and I sold it. You guys, please come along on this journey. This is Microsoft. Same thing. Do you see swings? Oh, people say it's like stealing candy from a baby, which I don't recommend. Especially it's October. Come on, you guys. Halloween. That's mean. Beatdown, right? Microsoft. Oh, run it. Take profit. Oh, beat down, right? Same thing. Gets a little pink right there. Boom, run it. And I wonder if could have possibly a 9 count come on. Oh, yes. Also, you guys, we have a last call. This is your last and final warning, okay? If you are going to get out, you got to get out now. We're under the 200. new ETFs, money managers. Guys, $100 trillions of doll hairs. They're warning you. Money managers with $100 trillion confront end of the bull market. We have bull markets and we have bear markets. Everyone is starting to bleed cash right now. They're bleeding all over the place. They're like, what happened? See, it's so good and then it's not so good and then it's so good. But for you, again, it doesn't matter. Mark it up, make money. Mark it down, make more money. So you guys, people aren't even gonna say bear market until we cross the 20, which we're currently only at about 8% from the top. But guys, here, it's right here. If you want to beat everyone to it, it's the 200. By the time mainstream media starts getting like, okay, we're at 20%. All right, bear market, you're already too late to the game. Also, coming in from the man with so much power, Bill, didn't know you had it in you. He's flipping. And dang, man, I wish I could move markets like that. Bill Ackman covers bet against treasuries. You're at the bottom, my friend. This is probably not a good time to short. I mean, a good time to short would have been TLT on that Head and Shoulders, but I went the wrong way. He decided to bet against the bonds. Says too much risk in the world to bet against bonds. James Bonds. And this, I was like, this is a good buying zone. Well, that's even better. I mean, to move the bond market almost a 1.5%. This is just by coinky dink. It's like Jerome Powell's power. Also, did you see, since I'm here, that Bitcoin pump? Dang, look at you. 31,000 ripping. Go, Bitcoin, go. Well, that is until you find resistance on that white line right there. Aw, dang, burn it. Also, here, let me draw another line there. You're going to have resistance right there, too. Be ready for a pullback, but bull market. Congratulations, Bitcoin. You finally got out of it. There's some... say probably start accumulating 25, make it down here. That would be your 20. So much to do with that 200 day. Got above it again. So congratulations, you keep on a going. Also, for those of you like, when I've had this line up for about 17 years, make sure, wait for the pullback. It's this line, that's your halvening. Gotta cut that supply in half. But since I am talking about Bitcoin, I gotta go the other side. Peter Schiff. Cat likes gold, which I do too. I love gold, I love Bitcoin. And I know the problems with Bitcoin too. Get it off, in, you know, when the government's like illegal, you know, and then you try to get it off of an exchange or they come after exchanges and things like that. It makes it a little dicey. Governments don't want you messing with their monopoly. Peter Schiff, this is the most obvious financial crisis that no one sees coming. Well, Peter, I do. See, there's things that we can agree on, disagree on, still be friends. I've had Peter on 2 or 3 times. We actually did talk a lot. Actually, my daughter, we talked about Bitcoin. Because I'm like, you know what? Long-term, go. You know, you should be fine. And long-term, with gold or with silver, you should be fine. It's the way it is. Fiat goes to zero. The mainstream continues to insist that the economy is fine. Inflation is beat. A soft landing is in play. But in this podcast, it's not true. It's obvious. We're looking at a financial crisis. Now, this is, of course, the early stages of the financial crisis. It is unfolding before your eyes. And then he says, if you are awake or smart enough to recognize what you see, but it's going to get a lot worse. Have I not said that? And I say, yes, it's going to get a lot worse. Take advantage of it. And talking about taking advantage, see the little red flags? That's when I launched my swing trade bull market all the way to the top. What's that flag? Bear market, make money going down. What's that flag? Right here, make the most money and learn how to trade options. And boy, oh boy, is there so much money to be made to the downside. I am down, guys. If you want to just, you know, I'm just going to collect, you know, money, you know, gold, silver. I'm okay with that too. I mean, I have been giving you, if you've been on this channel long enough, like step by step, this is what's going to happen, you know, right? As the world burns. And I said, what you saw a few years ago is going to happen again. So get out of the cities. Have you guys seen this? I can't even show it to you because YouTube will boot me. They'll say that's violence, but I can't even use that word either. Gosh, so annoying. Mob shuts down Minneapolis streets, terrorizes motorists. It's huge. Not just that, it's growing. Like always, I don't have a dog in this fight. I'm just here warning you, get out of the cities. I mean, feel free to take sides, get picket signs, burn things. Well, don't do that. But you're not going to solve anything. Nothing's going to get fixed. Nothing's going to get solved. What you need to be doing, same thing I've been saying for 5 years on this channel, start a business. Trade equities. Ta-da! Be careful that you don't have jobs because soon you're not going to have one. Freight brokerage bubble bursting. As freight markets facing long winter. That's so weird. I thought, okay, so you need trucks to bring goods and not services. You're not really going to service anyone. Goods, the goods, no goods. No one's right? I thought the economy was strong. If the economy was so strong, this would not be happening. If the economy was so strong, I wouldn't be reading articles like this. It's not, it's fake. It's all, they tell you one thing and you're like, why am I starving to death? You're fine. You're fine. How living in your mom's basement has replaced the American dream. U.S. college graduates cannot afford the glorious consumerism that has come to define the nation. And as long as we are in a debt-based system, it's going to get worse and worse. And you, whether you're the top 1% or 50%, you're going to get all, you're going one way or the other, right? Anything in motion stays in motion. So hopefully you're not just sitting there on the couch, but you're progressing forward. You have to. There is no retirement. There is no golden years. You're going to work every single day of your life. Just make sure you're doing something that you love doing. I do. I love doing this. That's why I do it every single day. It's like a great white shark. Do you know what happens to a great white? I'm like a great white shark. What happens to the great white if he stops swimming? He dies. And what happens to Johnny Bravo if he doesn't post a video every day? He dies. Start businesses. Do what you love to do. Live the life that you want. These kids go to college, get bachelors. I witnessed this when I taught college and high school. I witnessed them like going in, coming out, and like, nope, can't survive. Oh, that's weird. Now you're stuck with student loan debt. Wow, maybe you should have listened to me and started businesses. According to a July survey by Life and My Fitness, half of borrowers, this is step one, half of borrowers do not earn enough to cover the cost of their student loan payments, which is a problem, a 3-year moratorium on their payments. And then this article goes on to say 29-year-olds, almost half of 29-year-olds, they can't make it. They got to live at home. What do you guys think? You don't have to put a comment in the comment section, but if you want to, you can. You think this is going to get better or worse? I'm going to go with it's going to get worse. So again, get in motion. Take advantage of the things that I set down. I set it down. You pick it up. No dog in this fight. I do not want to lead you astray. I just want to put this stuff in here so you can do it. Like always, I love you guys and I will see you tomorrow because I have to work.